Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 32 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. The topic is Rocket Propulsion Part 2. So in the earlier lecture, we introduced the rocket propulsion and its types. We discussed the theory of rocket propulsion, performance parameters of the rocket propulsion like thrust produced, specific impulse, efficiency, propulsive efficiency, thermal efficiency, and we explain the working of liquid propellant rockets. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the other types of rocket, working principle of other type of rocket, solid propellant rocket, hybrid propellant rocket, nuclear rocket, solar rocket, electrical rocket. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the working of solid propellant rocket, describe the hybrid propellant rocket and explain nuclear rocket. So this is the diagram of the solid propellant rocket. You may find a metal case, a cylindrical metal case, and inside the metal case we have a liner, then the layer of propellant. At the center, we have the combustion chamber. At the top of the cylindrical rocket, we have the igniter. And at the bottom of the cylindrical rocket, solid propellant rocket, we have the exhaust nozzle. So here, inside the cylindrical metal case, we have a lining material. So the lining material will prevent the reaction of the propellant with the metal wall, and the propellant here, in the solid propellant, the fuel and the oxidizer, they are formed, mixed together, and they are powdered by means of grinding process. They are made into powder and they are mixed with the proper proportion for efficient combustion, and they are packed inside the cylinder in a particular shape. So using the packing, they are pressed together. So there are three processes involved in the packing of solid propellant inside the rocket. One is grinding, so making the propellant into fuel and oxidizer into powder, and mixing with the proper proportion fuel and oxidizer, and then packing. So in the packing, we are pressing the powder in the form of a particular shape inside the container. And using the igniter, we are initiating the combustion. So using the electrical spark, we are initiating the combustion, and the combustion of the propellant is taking place in the area where this is called as combustion chamber, center of the cylindrical rocket. And the solid propellant, they are consumed. So if you look at here, this is the thickness of the propellant layer on both sides, and when the combustion is taking place, so the solid propellant, fuel and the oxidizer, they are consumed by the flame, and the hot gases are produced, and the hot gases are expanded through the convergent divergent nozzle, gas nozzle. So the gas jet is produced. Using the gas jet, the thrust is produced, and the thrust, using the thrust, the rocket, entire rocket is moving in the opposite direction. There are two types of solid propellant. So the solid propellant, they may be heterogeneous or composite propellant or homogeneous mixture of organic substances. So in the heterogeneous, there is a separate oxidizer and the fuel. The different types of oxidizers are ammonium nitrate, potassium nitrate, ammonium percolate, potassium percolate. And the fuels are polymers, plastics and PVC. So they are prepared. So they are made into powder by means of grinding process, and they are mixed together and packed inside the cylinder. Homogeneous mixture of organic substances, nitroglycerin and nitrocellulose are the homogeneous mixture of organic substances which combine the properties of fuel and the oxidizer. So when you have a homogeneous mixture, when you initiate the combustion, so automatically they split into fuel and oxidizer, and the burning of the fuel is taking place in the presence of the oxidizer. The desirable properties of the solid propellant. So the propellant, fuel and oxidizer, they are mixed together. The propellant material should be abundantly available at low cost and safe to handle. So this is the economical point of view. It should be available in large quantity at low cost. Physical and chemical properties should not change during the process. So there are, I said, there are three processes: grinding, mixing and the packing. So packing, in the packing we are pressing. So in all the three process, the properties should not change. It should be safe and easy to grind, mix and cast into required shape to prepare the propellant grind. So these are all the process: grinding, mixing and casting. Casting means packing into a particular shape. The propellant should be chemically inert before ignition. They should not chemically react on their own. If it happens, the explosion may happen at any stage of the preparation of the solid propellant. The heat energy released during the combustion should be higher. So it should have higher heat release rate. The propellant should have lower molecular weight, higher density and higher mechanical strength. These are all the properties of the propellant so that they can be effectively packed inside the rocket cylinder. The gas jet produced should be smokeless and colorless. So that means there should be effective combustion inside the combustion chamber. The propellant grain should not chemically react with the metal casing. So to protect the reaction, we have a lining material. In addition to that, it should not chemically react with the metal. The propellant should not chemically react with the atmospheric air or moisture, and it should not be hydroscopic. So it should not, so when we are preparing the propellant and when we are packing during the processing, grinding, mixing and casting, it should not react with the atmospheric air and it should not absorb the moisture. So moisture in the atmospheric air should not be absorbed by the propellant. So these are all the desirable properties of the propellant used in the solid propellant rocket. And the burning of the solid propellant, how the combustion is taking place. So based on the casting of the propellant grain in the solid propellant rocket engine, the combustion may be regressive combustion, neutral combustion or progressive combustion. So there are three different types of combustion method. So once the initiate the combustion of the propellant inside the combustion chamber, so how the heat release, what is the heat release pattern, how the heat is released, and that is measured by means of the thrust. So what is the thrust produced by the gas jet? So based on that we have regressive combustion, neutral combustion and progressive combustion. So all the three combustions are diagrammatically explained here. So this is the regressive combustion, neutral combustion and the progressive combustion. So the x-axis we have the time. So from the start of combustion, initiating the combustion, the time is taken in the x-axis and the thrust produced by the gas jet is taken in the y-axis. Initially, if you look at the regressive combustion, the thrust produced is increasing. So once the combustion is started, so there is heat generation, the gases are produced and the thrust produced suddenly it is increasing and after some time it is gradually decreasing. So this is due to the consumption of the propellant. So when the propellant quantity is less, the heat produced also decreasing, and at the end of the combustion, so when all the propellants are exhausted, so there is no thrust produced. So this is called as regressive combustion. And the types of combustion and the thrust produced depending on the arrangement of the propellant grain. So in the next slide we may see the different types of arrangement. So this is regressive combustion. So when the amount of propellant is decreasing, the amount of heat release and thrust produced also decreasing. And another type of combustion is neutral combustion. Now here the thrust produced is increasing and it is maintained constant for some time. Then it is decreases sharply and suddenly it decreases to the zero level. The thrust produced will be zero level. And here, depending on the combustion pattern, depending on the arrangement of the propellant and combustion, this is called as neutral combustion. And the progressive combustion, so initially the combustion is initiated here and the combustion thrust is increasing, and then it is increasing further, slowly it is increasing. So it is suddenly raised to a higher value, then maintained, slowly it is increasing to a maximum value, then it decreases. That is called as progressive combustion. So depending on the requirement, So we may arrange for the combustion, regressive combustion, neutral combustion and the progressive combustion depending on the application of the solid propellant rocket. And there are restricted combustion. So in order to obtain thrust as desired rate, restricted combustion of solid propellant is preferred. So this may be, there are different types of method, cigarette burning or end burning, internal burning and neutral burning. Cigarette burning and or end burning. So this is what the cigarette burning, the combustion surface recedes leftward, the combustion surface area remains constant and the constant thrust profile is obtained. So when you pack like this, the propellant grain is packed to the entire cylindrical volume and the combustion is taking place at the end of the propellant grain. So we initiate the combustion here and the combustion chamber, this is the combustion chamber, hot gas are produced and the heat is produced. The hot gas are expanded in the nozzle. Now the flame propagate in the leftward direction. The combustion surface recedes or it is going towards the left side. So if you look at the arrangement, the amount of propellant burning at a particular time, with respect to time, it is constant. So the amount of thrust produced is also constant. So this is the cigarette burning or end burning. Restricted combustion method. So, we have the cigarette burning or the end burning. The next is internal burning. The combustion takes place in the cavity provided at the center of the propellant grain along the axis. So, different shapes of the internal cavities are possible. It can be used to obtain the required thrust profile. So, we thrust profile, there are three types, regressive, neutral and progressive. Depending on the thrust profile required, we can arrange the propellant grain inside the rocket motor. And here, so we have the grain, propellant grains are packed with this cavity at the center. The shape of the cavity, here it is cylindrical, we can change the shape of the cavity depending on the thrust required at a particular time. And the combustion is taking place in the entire combustion chamber and the hot gas are expanded in the nozzle. And the neutral combustion. So for neutral combustion, the combustion occurs on the cylindrical surface of the propellant grain. So, the propellant is packed at the center and the combustion is taking place on the cylindrical surface. So, here again it is happening internal inside and it is on the outer surface of the cylinder and this is called as neutral combustion, neutral burning, and as we know in the neutral burning, the amount of thrust produced is kept, it is constant with respect to time. And the unrestricted combustion. So, unrestricted combustion, all surface of the propellant grain are exposed to the combustion except those with the support. The unrestricted combustion required large volume of empty space along with the propellant grain to sustain the combustion. The quantity of propellants packed is reduced for a given volume of the combustion chamber. So, the very, very small amount of propellant is packed with a larger vacant space so that there will be unrestricted combustion. And here in the unrestricted combustion, there will be sudden or sharp increase in the thrust generation and it will end within a shorter time. And the unrestricted combustion, there are three types, tubular grains, multiple hole grains or rod and tube grains. So, you look at here, this is tubular grain. So, we have two rod-like cylindrical, grain packing. And at the we have more space at the center and the side, so the combustion is taking place in all areas. And here again, multiple hole grains, so we have more number of cylindrical fuel rod. So the propellants are packed in the form of a cylinder, and the combustion is taking place on the cylindrical surface of the three cylinders. And here we have a central rod. So around the central rod, we have the two layer of tube-like structure of the propellant grain. And the combustion, so here we have one combustion chamber, here we have one combustion chamber and the combustion is taking place in the annular space. And advantages of solid propellant rocket motor. The design and construction is simple comparing with the liquid propellant rocket. So, in the liquid propellant rocket, we require a storage tank, we require regulation valve, we require the mechanism for circulating the fuel and the oxidizer to the combustion chamber. So, here everything is removed and it is very simple in design and preparing the construction of the solid propellant rocket. The feed system is not required. There are comparatively lighter for shorter range, short range and small size. They are comparatively lighter for short range and small size. So solid propellant motor, solid propellant rocket engines, they are used only for short range, and the size is also very small. The density of the solid propellant is high. Large quantity can be packed in a small space. So that is the advantage of the solid propellant rocket system. Feed pump and the liquid flow system are absent, so the vibration problem are eliminated. Much fewer and less frequent servicing problem. So the service problem is not there because there is no other mechanism. We just pack the propellant inside the cylinder and make it to burn, allow it to burn and produce the heat and the thrust. The disadvantage of solid propellant rocket motor, nozzle cooling is not possible. So in the case of liquid propellant rocket motor, so we have the propellant, liquid form of propellant, which can be circulated around the nozzle so that nozzle will be cooled. So here that is not possible. Nozzle cooling is not possible. Specific impulse is lesser than the liquid propellant rocket. So the amount of thrust produced is comparatively less with the liquid propellant rocket. So specific impulse is less. It is impossible to turn off the operation in the midway or emergency. So once the combustion starts, so we have to exhaust all the propellant available in the motor. So we cannot stop in between as in the case of liquid propellant rocket engine. It is difficult to control combustion and thrust produced. So once once the combustion starts, so we have to allow the exhaust of entire propellant. So we cannot stop in between, we cannot control. So the control of combustion is possible only during the design. So we have to properly design and pack the propellant in proper fashion. So once the combustion starts, so in midway we cannot regulate the combustion or control combustion or thrust to produce. Solid propellant rocket motors cannot be reused after recovery. So once it is exhausted, once all the propellant are burnt, so the entire motor become waste. So greater care is required in handling rocket before firing. So this is what, so it should be very carefully we have to handle, carefully we have to prepare or pack the propellant grind inside the rocket engine. Solid propellant rocket motor cannot be used for long duration mission. So long, so far it can be used only for short range applications like missiles. The exhaust nozzle experiences erosion due to the presence of solid particle in high temperature and high speed exhaust gases. So there are some experience. Erosion occurs in the nozzle surface, internal surface of the nozzle, due to the solid particle present in the gases which is traveling with high temperature and high speed. So their solid particles are traveling with the exhaust gases at a higher speed. So there is a possibility of erosion on the inner surface of the exhaust nozzle. So this is what about the solid propellant rocket engine. And the next one is hybrid propellant rocket engine. So hybrid propellant means there will be solid fuel and liquid oxidizer. And here we have the arrangement for the hybrid propellant rocket, and we have the solid fuel packing of the solid fuel here and in the cylinder, and we have a central combustion chamber at the end of the solid rocket body. We have the exhaust nozzle and the oxidizer is injected. So the liquid oxidizer is stored in a tank. We have a control valve using the high pressure gas. So the liquid oxidizer is pushed. So the flow of the liquid oxidizer is by means of the high pressure gas. By regulating the pressure of the gases, the liquid oxidizer is pushed downward, and using the valve we can regulate the quantity of oxidizer supplied to the rocket engine. So the oxidizer is entering here. Once the oxidizer, so there is an injector. So when the oxidizer is injected into the combustion chamber using the fuel, the fuel burning of the fuel is taking place. So the combustion of the fuel with the propellant with oxidizer is taking place, and the hot gas are produced, and the hot gas are expanded through the nozzle to produce the gas jet. So using the gas jet, the entire rocket engine is moving. Thrust is produced and they are moving forward. And the combination of fuel and the oxidizer for the hybrid propellant system, beryllium hydride is the fuel, beryllium hydride and fluorine is the one combination of fuel and oxidizer. Lithium hydride and the chlorine trifluoride is another combination. Lithium hydride and the nitrogen tetroxide is another combination. hydrocarbon CH2N, nitrogen tetroxide is another combination. These are all the combination of fuel and the oxidizer in the hybrid rocket system. And the next one, next type of rocket is nuclear rocket. And here, the propellant used, it may be hydrogen or helium. You look at the diagram of the nuclear rocket. We have a nuclear reactor, entire nuclear reactor, and we have a propellant pump and a turbine, and we have the propellant tank. And here we have a valve to regulate the quantity of the propellant, and here again we have the valve, and the arrangement is the propellant is circulated around the body of the nuclear reactor, including exhaust nozzle. And here we take certain amount of the propellant gases, the gas from here, and to run the turbine. And after expanding and producing work, the gases are again expanded in a turbine, exhaust turbine. So here inside the nuclear reactor, the heat is produced by the nuclear fission process and the heat is generated. So like your nuclear power plant, so we have a nuclear reaction, large amount of heat is generated by means of nuclear fission process. Now the propellant used here, hydrogen or the helium, there is no combustion. So the hydrogen or the helium, the gas absorbs the heat energy and it is completely converted into hot gases, and the hot gases are expanded in the nozzle to produce the thrust. And here for circulating the hydrogen, liquid hydrogen or helium, we require a pump. So propellant pump which circulates the liquid hydrogen in the pipeline, through the pipeline around the body of the nuclear reactor. So the liquid propellant absorbs the heat energy, and it is hot liquid propellant is entering the nuclear reactor, which absorbs the heat energy converted into gases of higher temperature with the higher enthalpy. Then the gases are expanded in the nozzle to produce the jet. And we require power for circulating the, for operating the pump, propellant pump. So for that we have a turbine, and a small quantity of gas is taken from the outlet of the nuclear reactor, from the gas chamber before the nozzle, and the hot gases are expanded in the turbine. This is again a gas turbine, and the expansion produces work, and the work is used for operating the propeller pump and other accessories in the rocket engine, and then it is exhausted and produces a small quantity of thrust. So this is the nuclear reactor. Another one is solar reactor. The solar rocket uses the heat energy radiated by the sun to heat the propellant like hydrogen and to produce high temperature gas, which is expanded through the nozzle to produce a thrust. So the solar energy, using the solar panel, we are getting the heat energy from the solar system, and using that heat energy we are heating the hydrogen propellant like hydrogen and to produce the high temperature gases, which are expanded in the nozzle to produce the thrust. An electrical rocket engine, the rockets in which thrust is produced by using the electric energy is called as electrical rocket engine. The electric energy is obtained from the nuclear reactor or photovoltaic cell. So photovoltaic cell, we can install the photovoltaic cell which will convert the solar energy into electric energy. Using that electric energy, we can operate the rocket engine. That is what electrical rocket engine. And we compare the jet engine and rocket engine. So in the earlier chapter we discussed the working of a jet engine or air breathing engine, and in this chapter we discussed the working of rocket engine, different types of rocket engine. Jet engine, we discussed the ramjet engine, turbojet engine, turbo propeller engine, pulse jet engine, scramjet engine. So all the jet engines we have discussed. In the rocket engine we discussed the solid propellant rocket, liquid propellant rocket, hybrid propellant rocket. So the comparison between these two. So air breathing engine or the jet engine, they have altitude limitation. So the air breathing engine, they are taking the atmospheric air for combustion. So it cannot be operated beyond the atmosphere. So we have to, the limitation, there is a limitation for altitude. Whereas rocket engine, there is no altitude limitation because it is carrying its own fuel and the oxidizer. So the atmospheric air is not at all taken for combustion. So there is no altitude limitation. It can work even in vacuum. The thrust decreases with the altitude. So in the case of jet engine, the thrust decreases with respect to altitude because the amount of oxygen available in the atmospheric air is decreasing. Whereas in the opposite, in the rocket engine, the thrust improves slightly with altitude because the effect of gravity is decreasing. When you move up in the atmosphere, the effect of gravity is decreasing. So thrust produced is slightly improves with the altitude. The rate of climb decreases with altitude in the case of air breathing engine, and rate of climb means the distance covered, the distance covered with respect to time, that is what rate of climb. It is increasing with respect to altitude in the case of rocket engine. The flight speed is less than the jet velocity because of the drag force. So the jet is produced, the gas jet is produced at the rear side of the jet engine, and the flight speed is slightly less than the jet velocity. So here flight speed is not limited, can be greater than the jet velocity in the case of rocket engine. The engine drag increases with the flight speed in the case of air breathing engine. Because of the presence of the atmospheric air, the drag force is increasing with the speed. Engine has no ram drag. Thrust is constant with respect to speed. These are all the comparison between air breathing engine and rocket engine. We stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You can refer to it for additional information in the subject. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the YouTube channel. Use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again with another video lecture in the Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. Until then, bye bye.